Hello friends, I would like to show you how to make a box for protecting a control box and how to unfold it in a 2D drawing you can glue to a plate and make it. So let's get started. Make a new document. Go to Image Workbench. Select the icon in the middle to open the image. I will put it in the description. Open it on the XY plane. It is the easiest to do. You can use other planes, but it is easiest to use the normal plane. See it from the top. Now press the scaling icon, the number 3 icon on the right. Type 90 millimeters. You can zoom with the mouse wheel. Select one side and make a horizontal line to the other side. It is making a text that tells you what to do. Now select the image on the combo view eller icon. Press OK and the object is scaled to the right size. Now go to part design, make a new sketch on the same XY top plane, press OK. Now we have to move the image so it is in the center. Select the image, go to placement position, move it X to the center, move it up to the top border. The FreeCAD version I'm using is 0.90, let's see, 22,234, it's a new version. Now select the polyline, draw a line, a straight line with an angle, press the M key to make an arch or a circle. In the top here, I will make a new circle to it reaches the horizontal coordinate system line. Press the right mouse key to stop. Press escape. Now select box select the three lines and the center line with the mouse key, left mouse key. Make a mirror function. Create symmetric geometry with it is icon up here. Now draw two horizontal lines from the one side to the other side. Make the distance from the lower point to the coordinate system point 50 millimeters. Close the sketch. Select the image, press the spacebar to remove it. Now we have a sketch that looks like the shape of a control box. Now give the sketch a name by pressing F2. I'll call it Start. Now go to Part Workbench. We are going to make a 2D offset of the sketch. Select the sketch. Select 2D offset, make it 3 mm larger around the first line we made. Press OK. Now select the first start sketch again, make a new one. We are going to make it, the first 3 mm was to get some distance to the control box, the next 3 mm is the alloy plate we are bending around the bottom of the box. So let's make a 2D offset again, then make it 3 millimeter for the distance to the box and 3 millimeter for the plate. Press OK. Now turn the start sketch off, select it and press the spacebar. Now it is away. Go to Draft Workbench. select the two of the eller two sketches that are 2D offsets by pressing the control key. You can take one at a time, but I'm taking both at the same time. Select the convert bidirectional between draft object and sketch icon, and you'll get two new sketches. Now you could delete the 2D offset sketches, but I'm just turning them off by pressing the spacebar. Now go to Sketch Workbench, select the two sketches we made, select Sketch, Merge Sketches, then it's making one sketch with the two sketches in. It's called sketch number 3 here. Now go back to Part Design, select the file name of the object, make a new body, move the number 3 sketch, the sketch that's containing the two sketches that are merged, to the new body. We can give it a name, let's call it Shell. Press F2, it's the outer shell. Now I'm thinking, take the sketch number 1 and move it to the first body. The sketch number 2 you can delete, but we're just turning it off by the spacebar. Now in the first body we have the start sketch, we are not going to use that anymore, and we have the new sketch. Right click the body and make it active. You can also double click it by the left mouse key. Now it's active, it's bulked the body. Select the sketch, make it 3 millimeter thick, press OK, and we will make some holes in it. Select the, you can see it here, select the plate, make a new sketch on it to make some holes. I'll just draw some, but you could set some measurements on. Some holes, you know how to do that, so I don't want to show that. And we have some holes in the plate. Now turn this sketch off, we can call it plate. Alu plate. We can 3 millimeter alu plate. Now turn it off by pressing the spacebar. Go to the number, the shell body we made. Double click it or right click, toggle active body. Now it's that active. Select the sketch, pad it 40 millimeters, press OK. Now make a new sketch in the XY top plane. Draw a square in the bottom. Make it the upper line 50 millimeters down from the coordinate system. Close the sketch. Create a pocket. Reverse direction. Through all, press OK. You can turn the grid on and off by pressing GR on the keyboard. GR minus purple. Select the two upper corners of the box and make a fillet of 7 millimeters. Now it looks like this. We can turn the button on again, and we have a box that looks like this. Now we are going to make a drawing so you can make it with your tools. Let's go to Draft Workbench again. Turn the 3mm yellow plate button off by pressing the spacebar. Now select I can see there are two small lines here. It's not, or when you have to select it all, select all face by pressing the control key. Also this small arrow here, or else you cannot unfold it. Let's try again. You can see it has to be selected at all, and then we'll make a shape binder. Now it is all selected. Select create a face binder object. Turn the shell off, the body with the shell off, and we have a face binder here. Now go to mesh design. Select the face binder, convert it to a mesh. You can see mesh here. Create mesh from shape. Press OK. Turn the face binder off. Select the mesh we made, and you can unwrap mesh in the mesh menu. And you get a flat line here. You can turn the face binder mesh off. When we are going to the technical drawing workbench, make a new paper, press the orange icon, take a paper landscape A4, the number 2 with a paper head, and we'll get a paper like this. You have to see it as you want it on the drawing, so we see it on, from the top. I don't know why the mesh workbench is making it is angled. It is not straight, but we can turn it. So select the shape in the combo view, select the paper, press insert a view, this icon. Select the view, now you can turn it, let's say 13 degrees, press F5 to update. No, it is minus 15 maybe, 14, F5 to update, it was too much, 14.5, it is like so, now it's straight, you can just try, F5 to update, move it up where you want it, and we need the button of the box. So turn that on by pressing the spacebar. Select it in the tree. It has to face like you want it on the paper. Yeah. Select insert view. And we'll get this one. If you want some measurements on the drawing, and if you want them red, you can go to Edit Preferences, Technical Drawing, Colors, Dimension, and set them to red instead of black. Press OK. Now you can select your two points on the drawing and hold the Control key. They are going to light up green. Select the measurement. And you'll get a measurement. We can make one horizontal on this one. No. There was three that were selected at the same time when it is not going to work. Now it's teasing me. Oh, no, still. Try again. Now there are two green ones, and we'll get a measurement here. You can see, if you want a name on in the corner, you can type something, control box. Control box protection or something, and it will be a very fine text here. So, and if you want the 3D model of the object, you just have to see it here. We have it. We can give it a nice color. Just select them both. Control D, or you can right click, select a color. We can give it a nice purple color here. And we have this beautiful box. You can get a picture of the box if you want it in here. Just select the two shapes in the tree and press the icon, and you'll get a nice picture here. If you're pressing the circle with the red line in, the red circle with a line in, you will remove all the points and you will have a beautiful drawing you can print out and glue it to a plate, and you cut it out and fold it and weld it, and you will have a nice box. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.